In this video, I'm going to do some chipping and rust effects on this Warhammer 40,000 Lehman Russ. Before I do anything else, I'm going to give the model a coat of gloss varnish using Vallejo Airs Gloss. I'll add this with nice even airbrushed coats, and then I'll take the weathering from there. This coat of varnish will bring out the texture of the old brush painting underneath, but I'm not worried about that because that'll disappear with a coat of matte varnish. But this gloss coat protects all of the paint underneath and allows me to use washes. These washes are acrylic washes rather than oil from Vallejo, and I'm going to use them because of the ease of cleanup and the quick drying time, which means I can move on. You can see here that the acrylic washes come out of the bottle quite thick. This isn't going to flow very well, not even over the gloss coat that I've put on. So I'm going to add a couple of drops of tap water, give that a quick mix, and it should flow nice and easy now it's quite runny. I'm happy with that consistency. So now I'm going to show you how the gloss coat helps the wash to flow around the model. Just by placing the loaded bristles of the brush on a detail line, you'll see how capillary action draws the wash along the details. This is a really basic technique, and it always forms the starting point of any weathering scheme. I'm just using this dark wash to pick out any details, add a little shadow, and also break up the large flat painted surface areas that we've got on this tank. Here you can see how the wash has helped to pick out all of those bolt heads and rivets. It's given me some nice shadows in all the recessed areas along the panel lines, and it's picked out those large chunky bolts on the side of the tank. Now I'm in place to add a matte coat. This matte varnish is a Vallejo Air product. It sprays straight from the airbrush, and you can see here it's knocked that texture that the gloss picked out straight off the model. The matte also gives a good surface on which you can paint with normal paints. Here I'm mixing up some US grey and some light camo green to form a highlight colour for some chipping effects. Chipping like this is a little tricky to get the hang of because it's a very finicky technique, but the finished effect is nice. You can usually find this kind of effect on the work of MIG or Mike Rinaldi if you're into military modelling. These guys are real masters at it. I'm still trying to get the hang of this technique. Basically, what you need to do is paint an area with the highlight colour to represent some exposed paint from a chip. Using a darker contrasting colour, then add a shadow or an exposed underlayer of paint inside of the highlight. This kind of chipping effect can look superb. Like I said, I'm still trying to get the hang of it fully, but if you give it a try, I think you'll find that the results are really quite pleasing. I'm just going to scoot around the model now and add the highlighted chips in a random fashion along any edge that's going to be susceptible to wear. Be careful when you're placing chipping effects that you don't put them in an area which won't be exposed to anything that could actually chip the paint. All of these chips are in a place where something might hit the actual tank itself. With that chipping in place, I'm going to move back to using the sepia wash from Vallejo. I've got a mixture here which is quite diluted, and I'm going to start adding some streaks with it. When using oils to make streaky or rain mark effects, the trick is to add more oil and then wipe it away. When using these acrylic washes, it's completely the opposite. You have to build up your layers in very, very diluted, transparent passes with the brush. As you can see here, the first layer has hardly done anything, so I'll add a second one on, but I'll make it slightly narrower. You can see now that the effect is starting to build up. These acrylic washes are great because they don't smell, you don't need any kind of strange thinners, and you can clean all your brushes in normal tap water. After just four layers, you can see how the streaky rust effect here is starting to build up. You can really go to town on the whole model with that, using different shades. Next up, I'm going to make some rusty track links to go on the front of the tank. I'll start by priming the track links with Vallejo's primer, straight from the airbrush. When this is dry, it's a great surface to paint on, and I'll paint these links with a variety of brown colours. This one's quite a dark red-brown, but to give it some variety, I'm going to switch to using a different colour, this light brown, for the next set of track links. Over these base coats, I'm going to use some glaze medium to mix up some Vallejo pigments. I've got a variety of rusty shades here from their range, which are available all over the place these days. And all I'm going to do is add a thin coat of the glaze medium straight onto the acrylic base coat, dip the brush in the pigments, and then let that soak into that glaze medium. Using the different tones, I'll mix the pigments quite literally on the model. I'll use plenty of lights and darks, and even a dusty tone as well to give it some sort of weathering in advance. And I'll do the same on the other track link, using the glaze medium as a base, and then just adding the pigments right on top. Don't be shy to use all the different shades. Rust goes all kinds of colours, so you're free to go wild with this one. Using the glaze medium again, I'm going to dilute some pigment. This will allow me to add it with a little piece of sponge. This will give me some random pinpricks of different tones and just adds a little bit of depth to it. And here you can see them on the model. These will benefit from some dark washes at a later date, but unfortunately, that's all I've got time for at the minute.